Ja, welcome to a new game with White. Der play d4, g6, ja. Okay, let's transpose back to an e4 setup. f4, Bishop g5. Lots of choice. Let's play Bishop to g5. Or f4. F4 looks very aggressive. Let's go f4. This Bishop g5 setup is quite interesting against those Pirtz modern setups. It's a bit more forceful against the Pirtz with the knight on f6. The modern, like in this case, against the modern, it is also interesting, but it's not as dangerous. I regard it as really good against the Pirtz. It should be, I think, good for a bit of an advantage. At least it's difficult for Black to play. Okay, so he very quickly got in e5 here, supported by the queen on a5. So how to proceed? He maybe threatens to take d4. Could be a problem. Okay, so maybe let's just castle long. He takes on d4, knight d4. I will have a useful tempo maybe later with knight b3. And I'm not sure that he wants to take on d4 anyway, as it opens up the position, and he's not exactly well developed. Yeah, this is a very, very cool move. Just saying, okay, I don't care about my development. Oh, maybe you can play this. It's maybe possible. Okay, if I drop back on h4, one issue is taking on f4, but like queen f4, g5, just forking. But after takes on f4, I also have e5, of course. I don't think he can take on f4. e5 looks really dangerous then for Black. Opening up the e-file. The only issue is if he takes e5, he has knight d5. And after knight takes d5, queen d2 would exchange queens, but Black's position looks like Swiss cheese after that. One issue here is if he would castle. Exactly, he's doing it. I can think about winning a pawn, like take e5, knight e5, d e f e, knight e5, and then bishop f6, queen h6, winning a pawn. Still, it's not clear if this is really beneficial. I also can just play f5, taking, and then f5 and g4. And I'm not sure I want to really take this pawn. It looks like looks looks a bit crude giving up the bishop. So take e5 and f5 maybe. Also moves like king b1 to consider here. Got lots of possibilities. Okay, so take here and f5. And I must play a move at some point. I just intend G4, G5 attacking directly. If he goes knight c5, then I will actually take on f6 and take on h6, because the position is more closed. Then I can, I think, afford to take. Wow. Really? Okay. Yeah, maybe you can play that. Looks really weak, but on h4 he's got g4. I mean, it's not able to open this up really quickly. Okay, so I need to clear e2 for the queen, and I want to play knight d2 to c4, regrouping using the weakened squares here. Controlling c4 now. And one idea is to play h4, of course. Yeah, need to go here. Now I've got a really nice bishop on c4. Very, very good piece. Okay, so let's try to open up here. Of course, h5, so that I don't want to exchange h5 to isolate the pawn here. And now I intend to just give the exchange to open up the position. So, yeah, should I do that? I cannot spend so much time now. It's probably not completely convincing, unfortunately. Yeah, this is maybe some draw offer that you should take from a positional point of view. Queen a6, but I don't want to make draws really in those games. Always feels like I'm robbing the spectators of something. It's still probably it still probably would have been the correct thing to do. Bishop e4 now, and he's seeing this. Check. Yeah, I've got a little bit of play as well. Queen a8 coming. Yeah, this was lucky, but I didn't want to make the draw. My position wise, I should have done so. Maybe we've got this coming, check. And it's a mate. Of course, I was probably lost here. Oh, it's actually a draw. Surprisingly, rook d2 and rook f2 is probably winning for black. And this is a draw, funny enough. But, what was the game? I'm sort of confused here. Ah, here I took. Yeah, this loses. Okay, but in time. F6 is a draw, funny. Ah, yeah, of course. It cannot go here. Of course, this is disaster. Needs to go here. And then bishop d3, of course. Of course, I'm threatening mate now. And if he takes, I have this funny perpetual. Aha, yeah, interesting. So in the game I took here, and now he's got some winning continuation, queen d4. And this now still queen d4, but this loses, of course, due to the mate. Okay, it was just the time trouble issue, and this was probably not so great. I have some time to prepare this. I don't need to sacrifice in this position. So maybe I should rather prepare this or regroup pieces, and this isn't so great. Yeah, interesting chess anyway. Thanks for watching.